at the Yakabuski Community Center in Barry's Bay. Lots of good parking here. And I'm gonna go out and do some trail maintenance. So Mark is my partner today. And we're off to check out the trails. We're gonna put up some sign markers and have a little bit of fun. Stay tuned. Some rain this morning. Not sure, don't think there was enough there to make mud, but it hopefully will calm the dust down. We're going to make our way through Barry's Bay here and get on to the trail. That's a pretty easy one. Yeah, Mark's little Yamaha, well, it's actually, it's not a little Yamaha. It's side by side here. It's kind of interesting how following his tracks, how much wider he is. I can go around obstacles that he has to come through. He's got that thing loaded down with some pretty cool toys. We've got some branch cutters, two chainsaws, two different kinds of post hammers for the signage. So this is kind of fun. And I think this is where we're starting off here. I'm not 100% sure. No, I guess we'll carry on a little further. Giving back to the trail system. We use them a lot, and keeping them clean and keeping them in good shape is makes this trail system one of the best systems in the area, that's for sure. Big area. We have people from all over North America that come and use them. Renfrew County 8. So we just installed our first two signs. Marker here, we got B trail. It's an easy trail and goes either way, so that's pretty cool. And the second one we installed, and this is going to be a neat little run here, is the 57 trail. And that one is an intermediate with the blue. And we've got the RC ATV sign up ahead and the lookout. So we're going to go and head up to the lookout, probably stop for a drink and maybe a bite to eat. And we're off. Type rocks, and we'll make our way up here. Pretty good incline. Chunky. Kind of pretty, nice breeze. Bugs are out in full force, I'll tell you. Downhill section we've had here. We've been climbing pretty steady ever since we got on this trail. I guess that's why they call it the lookout. Side friendly, no problem. He's moving right along here. He takes a completely different line through the ruts than I do. Obviously that wider wheel stance. And we got a good climb here. Coming up. I'm actually going to switch to the low range here. I don't think I need to be in four-wheel drive, but I will be just in case I got to do some maneuvering. is considered an intermediate trail. Not that difficult. You just got to take your time, pick your line. Don't turn on the hill, keep straight up. So far we've had no issues here. We are climbing fairly steeply. Too major. A couple of rocks have been higher than I like to go over, so I just made an avoidance. There's one here that's what I like to call an axle grabber, and there's no problem there. Still climbing. Not as steep though. Now this is chunky. Expect to see any mud. Nah, it's shallow. Here. There we go. Look at that view. Madawaska Valley. Doesn't get much better than that, folks. Hey, if things look a little bit different, it's because it's 2 days later. It's Friday, the 28th of June, and I'm back up at the lookout. I stopped the other video once we got up here because we had a lot of work to do, and it wasn't fair to Mark setting up the camera. I wanted to give you guys some good shots and give you a sense of what this area looks like. So I'm going to head back down the hill here, and we're actually going to take a different trail than we did coming up. I'm going to take trail number 159. Give you a look at that one. It's kind of a beautiful spot and should be fun. So let's make some trails here, make some tracks. Okay, got myself turned around. I'm gonna head back down to the intersection here from 157 to 159. There's a little warm-up shelter. Nice little place. Well, don't really need to warm up today, but if you're snowmobiling, it's a good spot to stop and have a hot chocolate or a coffee. Chat with the folks in your riding group and stay out of the wind. dogs are out in full force. Holy smokes, we had some rain last night. It's two nights in a row now that we've had rain. Nothing torrential or anything, but just enough to keep these guys motivated. And they're out with a vengeance. This trail is a little bit chunky, as I said when we were coming up. Take your time, pick your line. And little Can-Am here, it's got decent ground clearance. A little over 10 inches, and so you know, haven't scraped bottom yet. So this is the intersection here. I got 157, which is the way we came up, and we got 159. We're going to try this trail, and just a different route home. There's also a lodge off this trail, Speckle Lake Lodge. Get fuel, gas, food, lodging if you're up here. There's all kinds of places to stay that are right on the trails. You've got access to good parking for your vehicle and your trailer, and you're right on the trail for full riding. And into the woods. Section, and so the trail to Speckle Lake Lodge goes off this way, and the trail around on 159 goes off to the left here. So I think we'll go and just explore the 159 here. See here, we got 155 and we got 159. What to do? Well, I know 159 turns into a loop, so we'll follow it and try and get the loop done. Thank you. beautiful tall pines. It's getting a little rugged here. Soft stuff. It's fairly firm. I haven't slid in anything, any ruts yet, so things are drying up. Little trail. Lots of ups and downs, lots of twists and turns. Little technical areas to keep you entertained. I think this is a four-wheel drive section here. Just from the way I'm slipping and sliding. And we're back at the B trail. So that was a kind of a neat little loop there. Heading back to Barry's Bay. It's been a heck of a fun ride. Lots of new areas discovered today and beautiful scenery. Brings us to the end of the trail, back at the Paul J. Yakabuski Community Center in Barry's Bay. There's a truck. This is a good place to park. Lots of parking around here, and it's ATV friendly. Hope you enjoyed this tour, and there'll be some more coming up. So don't forget to subscribe, and as always, thanks for watching.